Welcome everyone. In this session, let us see how the fuses have to be selected for a particular application. So when we select a fuse, the fuse what we use might be used to protect an electrical equipment or to protect a lighting load or to protect the transformers. So the application varies. So while we are selecting a fuse, the first thing we should see to that is, in the case of motor or in the case of switching of on a transformer or the capacitor, the fuse should be able to withstand the momentary overcurrent. Okay, and the second thing is, when it is inserted, when the fuse is inserted in the circuit, it should ensure proper operation. That means it should ensure that whenever there is a overload or whenever there is a short circuit, the fuse has to operate. Okay, and next thing is, the third point is, when we are using a fuse in a electrical equipment, it might not be the only one protective device which is being used. You have a primary protection, you have backup protection. A circuit breaker might be acting as a primary protection, fuse might be acting as a backup protection. So in such a case, that this fuse should be able to discriminate with the other protective devices which is being used. And the last thing is, mainly the fuse what we select, it depends upon the type of load that we use. So whether our load is fixed or whether our load is variable. So depending upon the load which we are using, we have to select the fuse. So for the purpose of protection, the electric circuits we broadly classify as steady load circuits and fluctuating load circuits. So steady load circuit, as the name implies, the load is fixed. Okay, it is not very much fluctuating from its normal value. Example is a circuit of heating devices. So in that case, if it is a steady load, if we want to select a fuse so that it has to protect against both overload and short circuit, then the fuse what we select, it should have a current rating which is equal to or little higher than the steady state load current. Okay, and in case if the fuse is used to protect only against short circuit, then we should have a fuse rating which is very much greater than the normal load current. That means, say for example, 16 amps is the load current, then the fuse rating should be very much higher than 16 amperes. Okay, next is fluctuating load. Fluctuating load is where our load is having a very large fluctuations. Over there is a wide fluctuation in the load. And this especially occurs in the case of motors, transformers, capacitors, and fluorescent lighting. So the main criteria for selecting a fuse for fluctuating load is, the fuse, whatever we select, it should not fuse out under the transient conditions. Okay, so we need to select a fuse which is having a time current characteristics which is much above the transient correct characteristics of the load. So in case we have a motor, assuming that we know that the starting torque of the motor is very high, so if we assume that the starting current surge of the motor will remain for about 20 to 25 seconds. In that case, what we do is, we use a suitable cartridge type fuse which can withstand the starting current. Okay, So if in case we don't know what is the starting current, then we assume it to be around 5 times the full load current. So based on that we select the fuse. Next is fuses for capacitors. So if we are using a capacitor, as if we are using a fuse to protect the capacitor, then it is actually a very difficult task because you will have transient current surge during the switching operation. Therefore, what we use is, we use a cartridge fuse which will have a rated current which is about 50% greater than the rated current of the capacitor. Okay, in case we have a transformer or fluorescent lighting, we use a fuse which is having a rated current about 25 to 50% greater than the normal full load current of the apparatus. So next is how the discrimination takes place. That is, if we have two fuses, so how the discrimination can take place, as well as if we have fuse along with others, circuit breakers, then how the discrimination is taking place. When we have two or more protective devices, say for example two or more fuse or a fuse and a circuit breaker, this discrimination is very important. That is, discrimination is nothing but the correct operation of the correct protective device whenever a fault has occurred. Okay, so for proper discrimination, there should be coordination between the protective devices. So if we have two fuses, say for example, you can see in this diagram, we have two fuses. So this is a radial feeder. The fuse which is present near to the feeder is called as a major fuse, and the fuse which is present far away from the feeder is called as the minor fuse. So say suppose a fault occurs beyond F2, then the fault current will flow through both F1 and F2. So if there is no proper discrimination, then fuse F1 will also blow out, okay, along with fuse F2. So this shouldn't happen. So what will happen is the healthy section also will get damaged. So instead of that, if a fault occurs beyond F2, then only the F2 has to melt, or F2 has to break the circuit. So how is it possible? That is possible only with proper discrimination. So to obtain proper discrimination in this particular case, the pre-arcing time of the major fuse, that is F1, it should be very much greater than the total operating time of the minor fuse, which is F2. Okay, so that is how we can obtain a discrimination between two fuses. Say if we have a fuse and a overcurrent protective device, that is a relay. Okay, if we have a fuse and a circuit breaker, then the characteristics of the fuse and the characteristics of the overcurrent relay, it should be coordinated in such a way that the overcurrent relay will operate for the currents within the breaking capacity of the circuit breaker, and the fuse has to operate for faults of larger current. So if we see that this is the characteristics of a fuse and you have a characteristic of a overcurrent protective device, that is overcurrent relay, this is nothing but the dotted line is the capacity of the circuit breaker. So if the characteristics of fuse and characteristic of the overcurrent protective device is plotted on the same scale, we get a intersection point, that is at A. So the fuse should be selected such that the intersection of the characteristic of these two devices, that is the fuse and the overcurrent relay, must take place at this point A, which corresponds to 6 times the full load current. Okay, so in this case the fuse will act as a backup protection and the circuit breaker will act as a primary protection. In this way the discrimination has to be provided when you have two or more protective devices to protect the same electrical equipment. So whenever we select a fuse for a particular application, we should see what is the rated current, and we need to consider whether it is a steady load circuit or a fluctuating load circuit. Based on that, we have to select the fuse. Thank you for watching.